Ephesians chapter 3 lets us know that there are certain things that are hidden that are only revealed to the apostle and the prophet. That's Ephesians chapter 3 verse 5. Amos 3 and 7 lets us know, surely the Lord God doeth nothing, but he revealed his secrets unto his servants, the prophet. 2 Chronicles 20 and 20 said, if you believe God, you'll be established. But if you want prosperity, you got to believe the prophet. No wonder why the enemy has done everything he could to discredit the prophetic.
That's right.
The enemy does everything he can to discredit the prophetic because the enemy knows that your prosperity is connected to the prophetic. That a prophet can speak one word and it could change your life. Are y'all hearing me?
Yeah.
But many of you, you get discouraged so quickly. And you don't hold on to what the man of God tells you. If a true prophet ever gives you a word, I don't care what it looks like. Hold on to what he told you. Are y'all hearing me? Elijah showed up to King Ahab. He said, there ain't going to be no dew no rain this year, but according to my word.
Right.
That's the power of a prophet. A prophet has power to speak a word. You know what I mean? And the one word he speaks can change the forecast of your life. Your life in a different place. Yeah. So the enemy said, my job is to discredit the prophetic. My job is to make folk not believe in the prophets. To just be satisfied with the pastor. Thank God for the pastor. But there are certain things he don't reveal to the pastor. Ephesians is only revealed to the apostle and the prophet. When you're quiet again. Sure.
Sure.
In the ninth chapter of Samuel. Couldn't find him. In verse 6, he heard that there was a man of God in the city. The Bible said he called him a seer. He said, we heard a prophet is in town. Maybe if we go to him, he can tell us where it's at. I'm in the book.
That's right. That's right.
But guess what they said? They said, we understand the principle.
That's right.
Here's another thing that's bad about the church. Offering has been so abused that when you teach the principle of offering and you talk about money, people immediately think the preacher's after money. No, quiet.
Amen.
And the enemy wants you to look at offering the wrong way, or he wants you to look at giving the wrong way, because the enemy knows the only way you're going to receive is you got to what? So his job is to make you feel bad about giving. I ain't giving. I done gave enough. I done did all the giving I'm giving. The enemy's just sitting there laughing at you. Because he knows that as long as you close your hand, can nothing come in it. Not quiet, but it's more blessed to than to
receive.
Why is it more blessed to give than to receive? Because giving sets you up. See, giving is a setup for receiving. You understand? A couple of months ago, Lord spoke to me and told me to give $100,000 to somebody. And I did. I ain't get mad. I can't promise you. I smiled when I gave. The Bible says he likes a cheerful giver. That don't mean he don't take no other kind. He loves the cheerful giver. I said, well, you might not love me this time, but I ain't cheerful like this. Amen, but I let it go. Because I know when God, ever God asks me for a seed, he got a harvest on his mind. Amen. I was just in Richmond, Virginia on Friday. Holy Ghost spoke to me and said, call that couple. I said, come here, couple.
Yeah.
I said, Lord said, y'all live in the ghetto. I said, God said, y'all live in the hood. They cried. I said, God say, I mean, where you live there, you ain't got no room. It look bad. You're in terrible condition. They just cried. The Lord said, I said, the Lord told me to tell y'all, go find you a house. And I'm going to pay your mortgage for a whole year. Y'all quiet. That don't make me mad because I know God is setting somebody up to pay my mortgage. Y'all ain't saying that. But until you learn the power of giving. Y'all hear me? When they got ready to go to the prophet because they were looking for something, guess what they said? They said, we don't want to go to the man of God empty-handed.
That's right.
Reach him out. They said, what shall we bring the prophet that he may tell us our way? Can I teach you a secret? Shake your big head if you want to know. Come on, shake. Yeah, they know that it's big. You got a big head. Shake your big head.
That's good.
You want a prophet to prophesy? Come with an offering. Yeah. Man of God, I don't have much, but this is a seed that I want to give you. I want to honor you because I can't even talk to a lawyer without an offering. You can't go to the lawyer without a consultation fee. And you ain't gonna, you gotta pay him and you don't know if he gonna help you. You gotta pay him even if he lose the case. But the God I serve ain't never lost the case. God, I don't want to come before you empty-handed.
I hear you.
Take this offering. Receive this. Pray for him. As soon as you put that seed in his hand, in the spirit realm, your seed opens things.
That's good.
Now he's going off. Bam, your life just opened right up to him. Because seeds break cycles. Are y'all hearing me? That's the power of the prophetic. You got to trust the prophet even when the prophet don't tell you the process. Because most times, all the prophets see is the promise. All of us. Most times, all the prophets see is the end result. You sit up there mad. Well, I thought he told me this was going to happen, and that was going to happen. It is going to happen. But God didn't show him the in between. God is smart. God is like Uncle Sam. He show you joining the army. They show you coming out the army. They don't show you boot camp. They show you that. He said, uh-uh, he ain't joined the army. Never did fly. God shows you the promise. He shows you that I'm going to bless you. I'm going to favor you. I'm going to move in your life. I'm going to do great things in your life. That's what he showed you. He don't show you that your greatest enemies are in your own house. He don't show you that church people are turning on you. He don't show you that sometimes you're going to have to walk by yourself. You're crying in bed. He don't show you that you're going to really find out who your real friends are. Because if he shows you that, you forfeit the process. You wouldn't even want the promise. Most of us get discouraged. The prophet give you a word. This is going to happen in your life. God said, you're going to get this house. Ooh, you bucket. Now you and I, especially if you've been praying for a house. And the man of God comes in, God said, that house you've been praying for, you're going to take it. Ooh. You come, you shout all over the church. You need service. I'm like, ooh, that's a man of God. But 8 months later, you lose your job.
That's good.
3 months after that, your payments get behind on the house you need. No quiet now. Now I want to see what that shouting is doing. What is that doing? I want to see what that praise is doing. Whenever you get a prophetic word, the word of the Lord has to be tried. Most of you fail the trying process. Sometimes it gets worse and look totally contrary to what God told you. But I believe the prophet. I believe the prophet. And guess what happened? The minute you believe the prophet, look what happened. You need that prophet, right? You hold on to what the prophet tell you. You hold on to it, right? No matter what it look like, I believe the prophet.
Yes, sir.
Hold on to what he said. Yeah. Why? Because I believe him. I know God talks to him. See, that's what that widow woman had to believe.
Right.
When the prophet came to her house,
yeah,
she was about to bake a cake and die. And the prophet said, hold on, yeah, I know you want to eat, but feed me first. Yeah. That couldn't happen in the 21st century. If that happened right now in the headline news, preacher robs widow of her last meal. Be all over the news. But she knew he was a man of God. And she said, God, either way, if what he say happens, I'm in a good place. If what he say don't happen, I'm going to die anyway. So I'd rather die believing in God.
Good.
She held on to what the man of God told her. And the minute she held on to it, no matter what it looked like, no matter what it seemed like, guess what happened? God gave her overflow. That's the power of the prophetic. It has the power to change your life. But most of you will never experience the power of the prophetic because you really don't believe it. You got to hold on to the word that come out of the mouth of that prophet, my God, like you holding on to the air you breathe. Why? The man of God said it. Who said it? God's man said it. And when he speaks, I've seen too much he said, come to pass. I prophesied, and I told y'all. I said somebody else, that's a meeting before I always got something to say. Now, I told any of y'all who follow me on Periscope, social media, whatever you do, I told y'all first, before all this stuff went on, first thing I told you, is God said this election will be one of the most confusing elections we've ever had. Who heard me say that? Okay, now, the second thing I told y'all is everything, even concerning Donald Trump, was going to change in the month of March. tell y'all that?
Yes, you did.
Now, let me tell you how God is. God, even when God have you say that, I'll be on the edge of my seat saying, Lord, I heard you say that. Now, don't put me out there like that, Jesus. I've been telling God, now, Lord, don't do that to me. Come on now. The whole month of March, Donald Trump was going up. Looked like he was untouchable. Looked like nothing was going to happen to him. Nothing. On the 31st, on the 31st of March, he said, I told y'all he was going to say something.
Right.
You said it. Lose his influence. On the 31st of March, he
that's right.
Said that people who have abortions or whatever ought to be punished. Everybody turned on him.
Wow.
And slowly, he loses momentum.
That's good.
Y'all quiet. All right, Bobby. I told y'all, watch Rubio. That's all I told you.
That's all you said.
I'm still saying what the Lord said. Watch Rubio. Now, I told y'all, God said that this election, something's going to happen that is like never happened before. The party, the GOP, the Republican Party, hate Donald Trump so much.
That's right. You're talking.
His own party won't get behind him. Now, people say, who you vote for? I look for Jesus. I don't trust no politician. I look up to Jesus. I told y'all everything was going to change. I prophesied and told y'all. I told y'all this. I said, it's like I told the meteorologist is going to hate the day he became a meteorologist, because when they say this is going to happen, the tornado is going to happen. Now, I know I'm in the north, but it's springtime. I know this ain't normal, 28 degrees. It's a sign that things are changing. And stuff is about to happen out of season. You're going to be blessed when it ain't even time for you to be blessed. I got a word for somebody. Your miracle is about to come before schedule. Hey! When a prophet says something, hold on to it.
Yeah. That's right.
When God sends a prophet to your life, whatever he tells you to do, do it. Are y'all hearing me? That's one word.
That's good.
Change your life.
Amen. That's right.
Here's another problem most of y'all missing. You receive the word from the prophet. You believe the prophet. You obey the prophet. For a season.
Yeah.
But you don't stay connected.
Yeah.
Hosea 12 and 13. By a prophet, the Lord brought Israel out of Egypt. And by a prophet was he preserved. That's what most of you mess up. You receive the word from the prophet to come out, then you go back to the dear church. You go back to the dear church, they don't even believe in prophets. You go back to a dear church that talk about the voice that's been sent to bless you. Y'all quiet here. When God sent a prophet to your life to bless your life, you don't let nobody talk against that prophet. Touch not to my prophet. Well, y'all quiet here.
You're too quiet.
Yeah. Told somebody the other day. A friend of mine, somebody came in trying to tell him something about me. He's a listener. All I can tell you is, all that stuff y'all saying about me, I don't know. But I know this much. I'm a guy. Because in the ninth chapter of John, they brought accusations against Jesus.
Right.
Huh? They brought accusations against him. And that man, this man, he laid hands on him. That man said, listen, they say, they even went to the parents. Give him the parents and said, he's a lady, let him talk for himself. That man said, listen, if he a sinner, I don't know, he might be. Is he a saint? I don't know. He might be that too. Ain't none of that none of my business. All I can tell you is, I used to be walking around with a pole and couldn't see. But now, y'all ain't talking back to me here. Some of y'all testimony is, before God let you hear my voice, you was far away. But never since you've been connected to the anointing on my life, there's a passion, there's a drive to go after God with every fiber of your being. I need you to slap somebody and say, I'm going to another level. To shake somebody, tell them I'm after something. I'm after something. I'm after. I don't know who I'm talking to, but I need somebody who's hungry for God, who's desperate. That's the deer panic for the water brook. So panic, my soul after thee. I'm looking for about 30 people in here who's tired of church as usual and is desperate for a mighty move of the Holy Ghost to jump on your feet and shout glory. We see that? Oh. Over this room. Or some of you whose lives I've impacted. Spoken to your life. Declare the word of the Lord. Doctor said you were going to die, but you're still alive. People said you'd never make it, but you're still here. One word from God. Come here, Monique. One word from God. Come here. One word from God. Give me a mic. One word from God can change your life. Can it both stop? Give up, man. We're going to tell the whole thing. You got to hold on to what a prophet tell. Y'all may have heard me testify before about a woman in Detroit. Woman who I prophesied to at Ebenezer's church, Second Ebenezer, Bishop Ebenezer. Prophesied to her, and she gave $1,000, and I looked at it and said, add a zero to that check. That's $10,000. That's no little bit of money to be given up. This was in 2008, maybe 2009, in the heat of a recession.
Yeah.
Y'all quiet. You don't let situations... I'm talking about the Holy Ghost. Oh, let's see that. Father, breathe on this altar. Thank you for the doors that's open. Good measure. Press down. Shake it together. And what? What? I can hear you. Say it again. Tell somebody the blessing is coming to my house. Did you name your seed?
Yes.
But see, every time you give an offering, but you don't give it an assignment, you just give away money. When you put an assignment on your seed, it takes on something. I talk to my man the party, the GOP, the Republican Party, hate Donald Trump so much.
That's right. You're talking.
His own party won't get behind him. People say, who you vote for? I vote for Jesus. I don't trust no politician. I look up to Jesus. I told y'all everything was going to change. I promised I told y'all everything. I said, it's like I told the meteorologist is going to hate the day he became a meteorologist, because when they say this is going to happen, the total opposite is going to happen. Now, I know I'm in the north, but it's springtime. I know this ain't normal, 28 degrees. It's a sign that things are changing and stuff is about to happen out of season. You're going to be blessed when it ain't even time for you to be blessed. I got a word for somebody. Your miracle is about to come before schedule. Hey! When a prophet says something, hold on to it.
Yeah,
that's right.
When God sends a prophet to your life, whatever he tells you to do, do it. Are y'all hearing me? That's one word.
That's good.
Change your life.
Amen. That's right.
Here's another problem most of y'all missing. You receive the word from the prophet. You believe the prophet. You obey the prophet for a season.
Yeah.
But you don't stay connected.
Yeah.
Hosea 12 and 13. By a prophet, the Lord brought Israel out of Egypt, and by a prophet was he preserved. That's what most of you mess up. You receive the word from the prophet, you come out, then you go back to the dear church. You go back to the dear church, they don't even believe in the prophets. You go back to a dear church that talk about the voice that's been sent to bless you. Y'all quiet here. When God sent a prophet to your life to bless your life, you don't let nobody talk against that prophet. Touch not to my prophet. We all quiet in here.
We're too quiet.
A friend of mine, somebody came in trying to tell him something about me. He said, listen, all I can tell you is all that stuff y'all saying about me, I don't know. But I know this much. I'm a black. Wait. Because in the ninth chapter of John, they brought accusations against Jesus. They brought accusations against him. And that man, this man, he laid hands on him. That man said, listen, they even went to the parents. He discouraged. The prophet give you a word. This is going to happen in your life. God said, you're going to get this house. Ooh, you bucket. Are you not? Especially if you've been praying for a house. And the man of God comes in. God said that house you been burned, you gonna take. Woo! You gone, you shot all over the place. You need service. I'm like, ooh, that's a man of God. But 8 months later, you lose your job.
That's good.
3 months after that, your payments get behind on the house you need. No quiet now. Now I want to see where that shouting is there. Where's that been? I want to see where that praise has been. Whenever you get a prophetic word, the word of the Lord has to be tried. Most of you fail the trying process. Because sometimes it gets worse and look totally contrary to what God told you. But I believe the prophet. I believe the prophet. And guess what happened? The minute you believe the prophet, look what happened. You believe that prophet, right? You hold on to what the prophet tell you. You hold on to it, right? No matter what it look like, I believe the prophet.
Yes, sir.
Hold on to what he said. Yes. Why? Because I believe him. I know God talks to him. See, that's what that widow woman had to believe.
Right.
When the prophet came to her house,
yeah,
she was about to bake a cake and die. And the prophet said, hold on, dear. I know you want to eat, but feed me first. That couldn't happen in the 21st century. If that happened right now, the headline news, Preacher Rob's widow of her last meal. Be all over the news. But she knew he was a man of God. And she said, God, either way, if what he say happens, I'm in a good place. If what he say don't happen, I'm going to die anyway. So I'd rather die believing in God.
That's good.
She held on to what the man of God told her. And the minute she held on to it, no matter what it looked like, no matter what it seemed like, guess what happened? God gave her overflow. That's the power of the prophetic. It has the power to change your life. But most of you will never experience the power of the prophetic because you really don't believe it. You got to hold on to the word that come out of the mouth of that prophet, my God, like you holding on to the air you breathe. Why? The man of God said it. Who said it? God's man said it. And when he speaks, I've seen too much he say come to pass. Prophesied, and I told y'all. I'm saying somebody that's a meeting before I always got something to say. Now, I told any of y'all who follow me on Periscope, social media, whatever you do, I told y'all first, before all this stuff went on, first thing I told you is God said this election will be one of the most confusing elections we ever had. Who heard me say that? Okay, now, the second thing I told y'all is everything, even concerning Donald Trump, was going to change in the month of March. Did I tell you on that?
Yes, you did.
Now, let me tell you how God is. God, even when God had me say that I'd be on the edge of my seat, saying, Lord, I heard you say that now. Don't put me out there like that, Jesus. Let me tell you, God, now, Lord, you let me come on now. The whole month of March, Donald Trump was going up. Looked like he was untouchable. Looked like nothing was going to happen to him. Nothing. Give him the pastor said, Pastor, he's an angel. Let him talk for himself. That man said, listen, if he a sinner, I don't know. He might be. Is he a saint? I don't know. He might be that too. Ain't none of that none of my business. All I can tell you is, I used to be walking around with a pole and couldn't see. But now, y'all ain't talking back to me again. Some of y'all testimony is, before God let you hear my voice, you was far away. But never since you've been connected to the anointing on my life,
somebody and say, I'm going to another level. Get out of my shot. I need you to shake somebody, tell them I'm after something. I'm after something. I'm after. I don't know who I'm talking to, but I need somebody who's hungry for God, who's desperate. That's the deer panic for the water brook. So panic, my soul after thee. I'm looking for about 30 people in here who's tired of church as usual and is desperate for a mighty move of the Holy Ghost to jump on your feet and shout glory. We see that. Oh, over this room, are some of you whose lives I've impacted, spoken to your life. Declared the word of the Lord. Doctor said you were going to die, but you're still alive. People said you'd never make it, but you're still here. One word from God. Come here, Monique. One word from God. Come here. One word from God. Give me a mic. One word from God can change your life. Can they both stop? Give her a mic. We're going to tell the whole thing. You got to hold on to what a prophet tell. Y'all never heard me testify before about a woman in Detroit. Woman who I prophesied to at Evan's church, Second Ebenezer, Bishop Evan. Prophesied to her, and she gave $1,000, and I looked at it and said, add a zero to that check. That's $10,000. That's no little bit of money to be given up. This was in 2008, maybe 2009, in the heat of a recession.
Yeah.
Y'all quiet. You don't let situations. I'm talking about the Holy Ghost. Come and see that. Father, breathe on this altar. Thank you for the doors that's open. Good measure. Press down. Shake it together. And what? What? I can hear you. Say it again. Tell somebody the blessing is coming to my house. Did you name your seed? But see, every time you give an offering, but you don't give it an assignment, you just give away money. When you put an assignment on your seed, it takes on something. I talk to my money because money answers. The money can answer the need in here. Talk to your money. Tell your money you gotta come back. Tell somebody, I circulate money. And look at me, as soon as the DV is coming right back. I don't know who got it in your spirit. Come on, tell me, if I circulate money, I circulate seed. Know that there are certain things that are hidden that are only revealed to the apostle and the prophet. That's Ephesians chapter 3, verse 5. Amos 3 and 7 lets us know surely the Lord God doeth nothing, but he revealed his secrets unto his servants, the prophet. 2 Chronicles 20 and 20 said, if you believe God, you'll be established. But if you want prosperity, you gotta believe
to discredit the prophetic.
That's right.
The enemy does everything he can to discredit the prophetic because the enemy knows that your prosperity is connected to the prophetic. That a prophet can speak one word and it can change your life. Are y'all hearing me? But many of you get discouraged so quickly and you don't hold on to what the man of God tells you. If a true prophet ever gives you a word, I don't care what it looks like. Hold on to what he told you. Are y'all hearing me? When Elijah showed up to King Ahab, he said, ain't gonna be no dew no rain this year, but according to my word.
Right.
That's the power of a prophet. A prophet has power to speak a word. You know what I mean? And the one word he speaks can change the forecast of your life. Your life in a different place. So the enemy said, my job is to discredit the prophet. My job is to make folk not believe in the prophets. To just be satisfied with the pastor. Thank God for the pastor. But there are certain things he don't reveal to the pastor. Ephesians says it's only revealed to the apostle and the prophet. When you're quiet again.
Sure.
In the ninth chapter of Samuel, couldn't find him. Verse 6 said he heard that there was a man of God in the city. The Bible said he called him a seer. He said, we heard a prophet is in town. Maybe if we go to him, he can tell us where it's at. I'm in the book.
That's right.
But guess what they said? They said, we understand the principle.
That's right.
Here's another thing that's bad about the church. Offering has been so abused that when you teach the principle of offering and you talk about money, people immediately think the preacher's after money. Y'all quiet. And the enemy wants you to look at offering the wrong way, or he wants you to look at giving the wrong way, because the enemy knows the only way you gonna receive is you gotta what?
Yeah.
So his job is to make you feel bad about giving. I ain't giving. I done gave enough. I done did all the giving I'm giving. The enemy's just sitting there laughing at you. Because he knows that as long as you close your hand, can nothing come at it. Not quiet, but it's more blessed to
give
than to
receive.
Why is it more blessed to give than to receive? Because giving sets you up. See, giving is a setup for receiving. You understand? A couple of months ago, Lord spoke to me and told me to give $100,000 or something. And I did. I ain't get mad. I can't promise you. I smiled when I gave. The Bible says he likes a chill forgiver. That don't mean he don't take no other kind. He loves the chill forgiver. I said, well, you might not love me this time, but I ain't chill for like this. I know if God ever God asked me for a seed, he got a harvest on his mind. Yeah. Amen. I was just in Richmond, Virginia on Friday. Holy Ghost spoke to me and said, call that couple. I said, come here, couple.
Yeah.
I said, Lord said, y'all live in the ghetto. I said, God said, y'all live in the hood. They cried. I said, God said, I mean, where you live in, you ain't got no room. It look bad. You're in terrible condition. They just cried. The Lord said, I said, the Lord told me to tell y'all, go find you a house. And I'm going to pay your mortgage for a whole year. Y'all quiet. That don't make me mad because I know God is setting somebody up to pay my mortgage. Y'all ain't saying that. But until you learn the power of giving, y'all hear me? When they got ready to go to the prophet, because they were looking for something, guess what they said? They said, we don't want to go to the man of God empty-handed.
That's right.
Read your Bible. They said, what shall we bring the prophet that he may tell us our way? Can I teach you a secret? Shake your big head if you want to know. Come on, shake. Yeah, you know that it's big, but you got a big head. Shake your big head.
That's good.
You want a prophet to prophesy? Come with an offering. Man of God, I don't have much, but this is a seed that I want to give you. I want to honor you because I can't even talk to a lawyer without an offering. You can't go to the lawyer without a consultation fee. You don't even know. You got to pay him, and you don't know if he's going to help you. You got to pay him even if he lose the case. But the God I serve ain't never lost the case. God, I don't want to come before you empty-handed.
I hear you.
Take this offering. Receive this. Pray for it. As soon as you put that seed in his hand, in the spirit realm, your seed opens things.
It's good.
Now he going off. Bam! Your life just opened right up to him. Because seeds break cycles. Are y'all hearing me? That's the power of the prophetic. You got to trust the prophet even when the prophet don't tell you the process. Because most times, all the prophets see is the promise. All of us. Most times, all the prophets see is the end result. You sit up there mad. Well, I thought he told me this was going to happen, and that was going to happen. It is going to happen. But God didn't show him the in between. God is smart. God is like Uncle Sam. He show you joining the army, they show you coming out the army. They don't show you boot camp. They show you that. You say, I ain't joining the army. Never is lying. God shows you the promise. He shows you that I'm going to bless you. I'm going to favor you. I'm going to move in your life. I'm going to do great things in your life. That's what he showed you. He don't show you that your greatest enemy is in your own house. He don't show you that church people are turning on you. He don't show you that sometimes you're going to have to walk by yourself. You're quiet in there. He don't show you that you're going to really find out who your real friends are. Because if he shows you that, you forfeit the process. You wouldn't even want the promise. Most of us.